Hi everyone, I Preeti welcome you all to my YouTube channel Learn with Preeti Bedi. So finally you have booked your IELTS exam and you have started preparing for it. But now you are worried and confused about what is going to happen on the day of the test. Don't worry at all, because in this video I'm going to tell you exactly what you can expect on the day of the test, what all you can do before and during the test. So stay with me right till the end. And before we begin, make sure you subscribe to the channel, press the bell icon button so that you get notification for all my upcoming videos. Hit the like button to motivate me to come up with more videos for you. Now let's get started. If you're taking exam for the first time, these tips are definitely going to help you. And I want to tell you that generally the speaking section happens at a different date than the listening, reading and writing section. So most of the things that I'm going to talk about today would be focused on the listening, reading and writing section of the exam. I would also like to mention that these tips are for the paper-based exam. So first things first, let's talk about what to do a few days before the test date. Generally, you get a notification from IDP or British Council about the test center location at least 7 days or 5 days prior to the listening, reading and writing date of the exam. So what you can do is make sure you know the location. Make sure you know how to get there. I personally recommend that if it is possible, if you're not aware about the location, visit the place before the actual test date, so that you can avoid any hassle on the day of the test. So make sure that you know the location of the exam. In my case, the test center location for speaking section was different than that of the listening, reading and writing section. And if that's the case with you, I recommend that you must know both the test center locations. Make sure you have practiced well before the exam. To excel in the IELTS exam, one key factor to consider is practice. You must be aware with the IELTS test format and the question types, and for that you need good amount of practice. So make sure you practice well before the exam. We have been getting this advice from our elders since our childhood, that you should get a good night's sleep before the day of the exam. And that is what I'm going to recommend, because IELTS is all about focus. You need to focus well. You need to be alert in the exam, and that only happens when you're not tired. So don't worry about what is going to happen in the exam the next day. Make sure you get a good night's sleep. Take proper rest to perform better in the IELTS exam. Now let's talk about the day of the test. So make sure that you reach the venue on time. Generally, the test starts at 1 p.m. and you get a notification from IDP or British Council that you must reach the test center at 11:30 a.m. Now, why they ask you to reach a little early is because you have to go through a registration process, your pictures would be clicked, and that takes a lot of time because there are a lot of people who are coming in to take that exam. So make sure that you reach the venue on time. Next tip is to wear comfortable clothes, because you will be at the exam center right from 11:30 in the morning till 4 or 4:30 in the evening. So it is almost the whole day. So you need to be as comfortable as you can so that you can focus on the exam and not what you're wearing. So make sure you're wearing something comfortable. Third tip is especially for girls and even for boys who have long hair. As I said, that you have to go through a registration process and your pictures will be clicked. While the picture is being clicked, they ask you to tie your hair. So either you tie your hair before leaving the house, or you can just carry a small rubber band which you can use at the time of clicking the picture. I recommend that you eat a healthy and balanced breakfast, because once you are at the test center, you cannot eat anything from the start of the test till the end of the test. So make sure that you have had a good breakfast. Fifth tip is probably one of the most important tips that I'm going to talk about. You must carry your passport along with you, because no other IDs will be accepted, only passport. And along with that, you have to carry a colored photocopy of your passport. No black and white photocopy would be accepted. So make sure that you're carrying the passport and the colored photocopy of the first and the last page of your passport. Make sure to use the washroom before the test begins. It's not that you can't go to the washroom during the test, but obviously during the listening section, you don't want to miss out on any of the questions, so you won't leave the test center. And you can go to the washroom during the reading and the writing section, but that is your own time. So I'm sure that you don't want to waste even a single minute. So make sure that you use the washroom before the test begins. Now let's talk about what all things you can carry to the exam center. As I already mentioned, a passport and a photocopy of the passport is necessary. Apart from that, you are allowed to carry some stationery items, pen, pencil, eraser, sharpener, but you have to make sure that there are no wrappers on them and you must carry them loose in your hand. They should not be in a stationery pouch or box because that won't be allowed inside the test room. Generally, the water bottles are provided at the test center, but if you still want to carry a water bottle of your own, then you must carry only a transparent water bottle, no labels around the bottle. You can carry some money, but you have to put it in your pocket because the purse or the wallet would not be allowed in the test room. Now, I'll give you a list of the items that are not allowed at all, things that you cannot carry inside the exam room. These are: no mobile phones, no watches, no purse or wallet, no car or bike keys, no eatables are allowed, no paper of any sort, no electronic devices. If at all you're carrying any of these, you will have to deposit them at a counter which is just outside the test room. So I really hope that the information that I gave in this video would be helpful to you. These tips will help you prepare better for the exam day and what you can expect. And if you still have any questions, you can leave them in the comments and I'll make sure that you get a reply for all of your questions. I will see you in my next video. Till then, take care and good luck with your exam.